Hello, my lovely people, welcome back. Glossophobia, a number one fear of human being is glossophobia. What is glossophobia? Google and see what's the meaning for glossophobia. Don't ask me for the spelling, it's in the description, check it out. So it's actually the fear of public speaking. When we get on stage, we see hundreds and thousands of people looking at us and we don't know what to say. We run out of thoughts, our hands start so trembling and our legs start trembling and our face starts sweating and we get off the stage. Every one of us gone through it. And the matter of fact is, whatever fear that you have, when you confront it, that's when you're going to defeat the fear. It's simple as a dog that chases you on the road, and the moment you stand and look at the dog, it just runs away. That's what happens when you confront public speaking. Confront it and you're going to defeat it. How do I do that? Let me give you a few tips that I learned in the process of public speaking, in the journey of learning public speaking. The first and the foremost thing that we get on a stage, when we get on the stage, is what am I going to say? We all think about that. People will look at us and we tend to think, now people are looking at me, what should I say? And it's generally not about what you're going to say, I'm telling you, because nobody wants to listen to what you're going to say. It's about how you're going to say, how you're going to deliver the content. So let's talk about Martin Luther King's speech for a minute. I'm sure I keep talking about Martin Luther King because it has every element of public speaking. So if you look at the speech, Martin Luther King's speech in 1960, there were millions of people looking at him. He had a script to read and he just removed the script and he came up with his own impromptu speech at that moment. And he said, "I have a dream." When he said, "I have a dream," everyone was shocked and looking at him and trying to understand what he's trying to say. And that speech moved everybody, especially Black Americans. It created a revolution there. Why it created a revolution? It's not just because of the script or what's the content. It's more about how he delivered the speech. He could have said, "I have a dream," but he had that enthusiasm. He said, "I have a dream." And everybody's like, "Oh, there's a gospel. It sounds like a gospel to them." So they listened to him and they understood what he was saying. And then that created a massive impact on the Americans. So what I'm trying to say is, it's not just the content, it's the delivery. Both goes hand in hand. You may be thinking, so if I'm just focusing on how am I saying, what's the content part? Actually, it goes hand in hand. It's actually, let's take an analogy of a train. So a train that goes in a track, and the train is actually how you're saying, and the track is actually the content. If you have the content ready, and if the train is not going, why do we have the track? So it's more about both the combination. It both gels together, and both your content and your delivery both works together, and it comes up as a good speech. So when you get on the stage next time, don't just focus on what you're going to say, and just focus on how you're going to say that. Got it? Thank you. Now, the second and the most important fact is, be yourself. Be yourself. Just be who you are naturally when nobody is seeing you. Most of the time, what we do is, when we get on the stage, we try to enact someone, or when we try to do something for the first time that we've never tried. And that is not a good idea. That's not a stage to practice something new. It's a place where you have to show who you are. And be vulnerable on the stage. When I say vulnerable, just lose your hands and just look at the audience as who you are. Dumb, naked, stupid, whatever it is, just be who you are. And people will like you. If you are a dump on the stage, you're showing you are a dump, people will like you. People will laugh at you, but they will really like you. So who you are does really matters. Don't try to enact or don't try to do something. Just be yourself, take a deep breath and show who you are. Open up completely and show you are. Right? So that's the second tip that I have for you. And the third and the most important fact is, share stories. Share a lot of stories. We all love stories. Human beings are bar up sharing stories, right? We share stories with your wife if you're married. You share stories to your managers if you're working. Or maybe you're raised in a family where your grandma or grandpa would have told you a lot of stories. So story is in our DNA. Every single part of our DNA has stories. Who doesn't love stories? Yeah, kids or parents or grandparents, everybody likes stories, right? Share stories. And a tip that I have for sharing stories is to make a note of the things that happens in your life. Have a journal. The moment when you find something interesting, write it down. Everyone, definitely they see something interesting or they go through something interesting every single day. Just make a note of it in a journal or a note that you carry with yourself. Just make a note of it, or in your smartphone, make a note. Make a note, and every single day you collect a single story, and then it becomes a bunch of stories, right? When we say stories, people look after stories in internet. They Google stories. That's not how it works. You come up with your own stories, the incident that happens in your life, because you're talking for you. So share your stories, and personal stories has a great impact than anything else. So share a lot of stories. People will love to hear your stories. And that's all I have for you. So go through the three topics that I said, three tips that I shared with you. The first tip that I shared is, it's not what you're saying, it's how you're saying. Second is, be yourself, show who you are, be vulnerable. And the third and the most important one is, share stories. That's all I have for you, as I told you. Bye for now.